You have not been abandoned by the people of America. We stand with you shoulder to shoulder. You stand for a great Persian nation, a great Persian culture, and a great Persian civilization. And ever since 9/11, we in America have been asking, where is the other side of the Muslim world? Where is the other face of the Muslim world? The face of the Muslim world that craves freedom and democracy and dignity. And you have now shown it through your actions. You are one of the greatest generations that a great Iranian nation has produced. Your cause is just, your cause is right, and I want to say these final words to you. They have broken your bodies, but they cannot and will not break your spirit. And your spirit of the last 2 weeks has ignited a flame that will keep the Iranian nation and Iranian democracy alive for generations to come. We back you. We support you. Keep up your good fight. And I want you to know, it is always darkest before the daylight. Your cause is right, and you will triumph, and the American people will support you heart, mind, and soul. God bless you. Michael, back to you, my friend.
Thanks for the report, Jeff. I'll be right back. It's the Savage Nation.
Is your inheritance stuck in probate? Inheritance Funding Company can advance you the cash you need in as little as 72 hours. Go to inheritancefunding.com or call 877-U-AIR. That's 877-Y-O-U-H-E-I-R.
Doug Steffen, weekdays 2 to 5 a.m. on Talk 910 KNEW.
Some of the topics that we touched on today, in addition to meatball recipes on the Savage Nation, Obama's vacation. Oh, yeah. The media is now reporting that Obama's going to take a vacation on Martha's Vineyard. Now, I know why he's going to Martha's Vineyard. That's where all of the bankers from Wall Street, who he bailed out, have summer homes. You won't read that in the paper. He didn't pick Martha's Vineyard because he particularly loves it. He picked it because his friends on Wall Street invited him to see how else they can fleece the American people. Now, even though taking a vacation this year is a big deal, it's interesting to me that the media constantly criticize Bush for taking too much vacation time. We don't hear that this time around. And then I've asked you if you're taking a vacation somewhere, and is that somewhere in America where you can go where liberals do not bow in Chinese restaurants? Is there such a thing as a conservative vacation destination? And then Obama's media blitzkrieg. Every time the television is turned on, there he is. Every day, another press conference, another town hall meeting. And if it's not Michael Jackson or them not demanding that Mark Sanford resign, it's Obama at another Soviet-style health care plan meeting. Every other day, another town hall meeting. Every morning, there's a speech. How we need health care reform. Every hour, one of his flunkies on a cable news show talking about the need for socialized medicine. Goebbels, who was Hitler's propaganda minister, said that if you repeat a big lie often enough, people will eventually believe it. It looks like that where Obama's taking his press ideas from. It's like the same thing with everything. Everything is an action figure. They wind up governors. 1-800-449-8255, michaelsavage.com. Europe moves to the right, America swings to the left. And you ain't seen nothing yet. Obama's just warming up. 1-800-449-8255, michaelsavage.com. Go to the website. Go ahead. Look up the stories. Come on, I'm not taking calls on hair loss. Stop it. They're putting real crackpot callers up to you. No, I'll tell you. You want me to talk about hair loss? What do I know about hair loss? I lost hair. What should I tell you about that? I love that guy who wrote me the letter. He wants his first year in marriage to be worry-free. You hear this? I should pay for it. I remember when I had my first child, I would have loved to have 1 year worry-free. I haven't had a day worry-free yet. I'm 67. He wants a year.
The chief guru told him to have a year, worry-free years, so he could set off in life and do good for the world. Very nice. I'll tell you what my first year of marriage was with my first child. It was working 17 days a week. I would have loved a worry-free year. It would have been lovely to stay home and stroke my baby, you know, kiss my wife. Where does this come from, this idea that a religious person doesn't work? Whoever heard this? This is not even a biblical mandate. If you go back to the Bible, work was essentially a part of a human's life, whether they were religious or not. The guys in the temple, the Sanhedrin, the guys who condemned Christ, how many of them were there in the Sanhedrin? 10? I forgot already. Remember the movie The Passion of Jesus? There were like three judges that said, no, he didn't do that much. Don't kill him. Remember that? The other guy says, no, he's a troublemaker. Put him on the banned list. Give him the cross and tell him to take a walk. No, he didn't do anything, man. He was just telling people not to be too greedy. That's enough. We don't need him around. He's trouble. He's interfering with the giving. He's interfering with the giving. We need the money. And the people are like, wise up. Put him on the cross. He didn't do anything, three of them said. We don't care what you said. Seven said condemn him. That should go over well in Crown Heights. Yeah, that's... 1-800-449-825. You have to each his own. Leave me out of it, though. I don't know. The whole thing is getting to me now. It's like it's all coming full circle. Everything in my life is coming back to where it started. And it's just that I'm older with it. That's all. Just older. No different. I'm the same height. And you think about it. Nothing. Your height doesn't really change over time. Think about that. Well, it does. If you live long enough, everything goes and you shrink. That's the real kicker that God gives you. If you're lucky enough to live long enough, you lose every function in your body and you shrink in size. Perfect. What a reward for living a long and wonderful life. You shrivel up and every organ goes. Terrific. Great. What a scene. What a scene this is. Every day a joy. Every joy is every second another joy.
Savage. The Savage Nation.
Download the podcast at 910knew.com.
Playing Hawaiian music now in honor of Senator Dan Inouye. Play it louder. I want to hear the Hawaiian music. You see, the good Senator Inouye, who once had a distinguished record as a World War II hero, in fact, he left an arm in Europe as a great American hero, now he has thrown his reputation away. How? Apparently, he used his powers as a senator to demand that the Treasury Department help a bank that he just happens to be a board member on, that he just happened to found, that he just happens to have his most money invested in. Would you cut that music out? They can't hear me. Don't you have anything better than that piece of music? That's it. That's it. Now, that's the mood we want to create. Anyway, Senator Dan Inouye had his staff contact federal regulators to ask about the bailout application of an ailing Hawaiian bank that he had helped to establish and where he has invested the bulk of his personal estate. Well, that's terrible. You know, break that record, will you please? I'm sick of that, too. When you hear about this kind of corruption, everything seems sickening. Let's try one more piece of music. Not bad at all. Now, here's the worst part. 2 weeks after the inquiry from Inouye's office, Central Pacific Financial announced that the Treasury Department would inject $135 million of taxpayer money. Oh, my God. Something is rotten in the state of Hawaii other than the music. Oh, please, get rid of the Hawaiian music and give me something fast, like 3 minutes of rock and roll. Let's go to the you're talking at the hop. What are they doing now? If they're not dead from a heart attack already, they're in a retirement home in Florida deciding whether they want Italian or Chinese for dinner. But wait till it gets to the piano solo. Wait. Where did that energy of music go? Where in the world did it go? Play some music. Make believe it's Rock and Roll Friday. I'm already hitting a bad. There you. That's perfect. I love this. Who is it? Don't say it. Hold it. It's an Alzheimer's test. Hold on. Don't say a word. Not a word. No, not a word. No hints. Bobby Darin. Okay, be on the seat. I'm slower. I can tell you just by telling. I test my mind like that. That was slow. I can see I'm a little troubled now. I'm going to do this once or twice a week now and see my memory right on the air. You'll see it go downhill over the years. Till eventually I'm like, hello, this is the Savage Nation. I'm Michael Savage. Welcome to the show. We got quite a day for you here. Granted, I get nothing out of it. I don't get a rise out of it. This is nothing to me. How long ago? Grata Zura, forget about it.